units and dimensions. So here units, to understand units, let's suppose I'm taking one example, say 5 meter. So you can see that meter, that is giving us an idea about length. If I write 5 second, that second is giving us an idea about time, and 5 kg is giving us an idea about mass. So we can say that this something, right, which is giving us an idea about the physical quantity, that something is called unit. So we can write this as the physical quantity, that is Q, N is the numerical value, and U is unit. So that unit is something which is giving us an idea about the physical quantity Q. In case if they ask to convert 5 meter in centimeter, we write 5 meter as 500 centimeter. But if you take 5 meter and 500 centimeter, both are giving us an idea about length. So 5 is basically Q1, that is N1U1. Q1 is the length, 5 is N1, meter is U1, and Q2 is N2U2. But you can see that Q1 is equal to Q2, because in both the cases that Q1 Q2 remains L. Therefore we can say that N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2. So this is the basic formula to convert one system into other system. Now, as I just said, the system, so we have 4 system of units. So in the system of units, the first system is SI, which is the standard international system of unit, which is applicable throughout the globe, like Newton, Joule, etc. Second is MKS, which is meter, kilogram, second. So if we convert that Newton in MKS, which is kg meter per second square, that is called MKS system. Third is CGS, which is centimeter, gram, second. So if I convert this Newton in CGS, that will be gram, centimeter per second square. And the fourth, that is FPS, which is foot, pound, second. In India, we generally prefer MKS and CGS, and this SI is accepted throughout the globe, including India also. Now, how to use this N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2? So let's understand with the help of one example. For example, I have taken 1 kg meter per second square. In case if they ask to convert in gram centimeter per second square, so write N1, this is N1, this is U1, N2 we have to find, and that is U2. So N1 is 1, U1 is kg meter per second square, N2 we have to find, and that is gram centimeter per second square. Now 1 kg, that is 1000 gram. 1 meter, that is 100 centimeter per second square, and that is gram centimeter per second square. So that centimeter, centimeter, gram and gram gets cancelled, and we get N2 as 10 raised to power 5. So it means we can say that 1 kg meter per second square is 10 raised to power 5 gram centimeter per second square. So this is how we use N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2 as a conversion formula, converting one system to other system. So that's all what we have in brief in units. Dimensions. Now what is a dimension? To understand this, let's suppose I've taken an example of force, which is mass into acceleration. Now the standard unit of the force is Newton, which is kg meter per second square, which we can write it as kg to the power 1, meter to the power 1, and second to the power minus 2. Now if I write kg as m, meter as l, and second as t, we get m to the power 1, and here this is 1, and here this is minus 2, and if we put this in bracket, we get the dimensions 1, 1, minus 2. So now what do you mean by the dimensions? Dimensions means the power of m, l, and t. These powers, if I write separately, these powers are called dimensions. And why we put this bracket? This bracket signifies that we are talking about dimensional formula. So if we write MLT in the square bracket, that means this is a dimensional formula. And if we just talk about the powers only, that is called dimensions. And if I equate this with force, with the physical quantity, this part is called dimensional equation. So the difference is clear. Dimensions means the powers. Dimensional formula, if we write this in the square bracket. And dimensional equation means when you equate this with force. So now let's do some types of the dimensions. Types of dimensions. The first type, that is dimensional variable. Now what do you mean by dimensional variable? That means any physical quantity, the value of which is variable but does have some dimensions. For example, force, momentum, impulse, velocity, displacement, etc. all have some value, some variable value, but does have some dimensions. Like for force, we have just discussed, that is m1, l1, t minus 2. For momentum, that is mass into velocity, which is m1, l1, t minus 1, like that. So that is called dimensional variable. Second is dimensional constant. Now what is dimensional constant? As the name suggests, the value is constant but does have some dimensions. Example, small g, the acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.8 meter per second square. So the value, that is constant but does have some dimensions, which is L1 t minus 2. So the dimensions are 1 and minus 2. So that is called dimensional constant. Third, that is dimensionless constant. Dimensionless constant means the value is constant but does not have any dimensions. For example, pi, 1, 2, etc. So as you can see, like pi is 22/7, that is having a fixed value. 1, 2, these are also constants. So that is called dimensionless constant. And the fourth, the last one, that is dimensionless variable. Now the dimensionless variable means which has some value, but that is dimensionless. For example, relative density. Relative density, which is density of the substance upon density of water. So as this is kg per meter cube upon kg per meter cube, that gives no unit and hence no dimensions. So that is called dimensionless, but the value is variable. Applications of dimensions. First application is conversion. Conversion from one system to other system. So to understand this, let's suppose I've taken N1U1 is equal to N2U2. Now N1, write it as it is. U1 as M1 to the power A, L1 to the power B, T1 to the power C, and N2, U2 you can write M2 to the power A, L2 to the power B, and T2 to the power C. Because you can see that M1 will change to M2, like kg to gram, meter to centimeter, second to minute, but the dimensions remain same. So that M2 can be written as N1, and if you take this down, you get M1 by M2 to the power A, L1 by L2 to the power B, T1 by T2 to the power C. So this is the standard formula to convert one system to other system using dimensions. If we take one example to make it more clear, for example, 1 newton, that is dash dyne. Now we first have to find the dimensions of newton, which is 1, 1, minus 2. So if we put it over here, N1, that is 1, and write this first like this, and here write the dimensions, which is 1, 1, minus 2. Now Newton, that is in kg, meter, second, and dyne, that is a CGS, which is gram, centimeter, second. So that second and second gets cancelled. kg is 10 raised to power 3 gram. Here meter is 10 raised to power 2 centimeter. So that you get 10 raised to power 5. So this is how we convert one system to another. Second application is checking the accuracy. To understand this, they can give you any formula. I'm taking very simple formula. Let's suppose energy, that is mc square. Okay. And they ask you to check whether this formula is dimensionally correct or not. So to understand this, let's suppose I'm taking LHS first. And here you put the energy in the dimensions. And we know that the dimensional formula for energy is m1 l2 t minus 2. Similarly, you take RHS. And here you put the square bracket with mc square, that is capital M. Speed is L1 t minus 1 to the power 2. So that we get m1 l2 t minus 2. So now here you can see that LHS, that is equal to RHS. So it means this formula is dimensionally correct. But there are some limitations also, that in case if they give you half mc square, or let's suppose 3 by 2 mc square, in that case, this formula is dimensionally correct, but actually this formula is wrong. So you can't make a decision that the formula is actually correct or not. So this is just to verify the formula dimensionally only. So this is how we do it. Now the third application, which is very important, that is the derivation of formula. How we can derive the formula? Now they will give you some three quantities. For example, I'm writing, say, energy, that is proportional to m, v, and let's suppose density. So E, that is proportional to m to the power x, v to the power y, and rho to the power z. Now to remove this proportionality, let's suppose a constant k is used, that is m to the power x, v to the power y, and rho to the power z. Now you just put the dimensions, which is m1, l2, t minus 2 with the bracket, and here m to the power x, l1 t minus 1 to the power y, and the density is mass upon volume, so m1 l minus 3 to the power z, so that you get m to the power x plus z, l to the power y minus 3z, and t to the power minus y, that is m1 L2 t minus 2. If you just compare the power, like m to the power 1, that is equal to m to the power x plus z. Similarly, 2 with y minus 3z. Similarly, minus 2 with minus y. So that you get y is equal to 2. So that if you put this value of y in this, you get z is equal to 0. And here you get x is equal to 1. So that the formula is coming E proportional to m to the power x, v to the power 2, and rho to the power 0. So that E is coming k m v square, where k is the constant of proportionality. Now here the limitation of this is, you can't judge about this value of k. You can't find it out from this formula. Second, you can use this to maximum three quantities only. So I hope this is clear to you all. Thank you.